In this video, we will briefly cover the entire client profile screen and go over the most commonly used sections in detail. Here, we'll be looking at the client profile for Jane Smith. We'll enter her name in the top left search field. If the client you need to access does not have a profile, please see our Adding Clients video for instructions on adding a client. In addition, if there's anything in this video you'd like more information on, please see our Client Profile Screen Overview article for more in-depth coverage of each feature. You can easily access that article by clicking the blue eye icon on the top left of the client profile screen. To see all the client profile information at once, you may click the Expand All option. You may then choose Collapse All to close all the sections again. Clicking Save View will save the current sections you have open and closed. This saves time by preventing you from having to open and close the same sections each time you access a client profile, and the setting applies to all client profiles. You may deactivate the client profile on the top right by clicking the Deactivate button. This will also deactivate their profile and account, but you will be able to reactivate it again later if you need to. You may also use the Tools button to set this page as the client lookup landing page, which means you'll be brought to the client profile screen first when looking up a client instead of the client home screen. You can also select the Merge Duplicate Clients option if the client has more than one profile. There are a number of different sections on this page, which we'll go over now. The Edit Name section enables you to assign an ID and enter the client's first and last name. An ID will be assigned automatically. However, you can click Assign to swipe a card and have its ID number be paired with the profile, or enter a custom ID number manually. If this client is a prospect who has yet to make a purchase or visit your business, or if this is a business and not an individual person, you can check either of those boxes at the top. The Contact section enables you to enter the client's email address, phone number, and create a login. When you click on Setup, you'll be brought to a different page where you may enter a password for the client to use when logging into consumer mode. The welcome email can be used to give the client instructions for logging in. Once added, you may then click Edit to change the email address or password, or click Delete to remove the client's login. The Subscription section at the bottom gives you the ability to enable or disable clients from three types of notifications. All three notifications can be sent via email or text, and they correspond to three different categories of auto emails. The Account Management subscription will send notifications regarding the client's contracts or auto pays. You can find the related auto emails in the Account Updates section of the Auto Email screen. The Reminders and Schedule Changes subscription sends notifications regarding services that the client has booked. You can find the related auto emails in the Client Schedule section of the Auto Email screen. The News and Promos subscription includes marketing communications. You can locate the related auto emails in the Promotional section of the Auto Email screen. If the text box next to the News and Promos is grayed out and your client wishes to opt in, you'll need to ask them to log into their account online to check the box. You and your staff can opt out your clients from receiving text notifications at any time. Due to differences in anti-spam laws, the email box will default to checked for the clients in the US and default to unchecked for clients in other countries. The Address section is self-explanatory, and as a shortcut, you may swipe the client's ID so that their address information will populate automatically in those fields. Additional information is where the client's birthday, gender, and liability waiver is located. You may add additional genders under the gender setting and choose between three options in the gender preference dropdown. Both the insurance and emergency contact information sections are again self-explanatory, Simply enter in the information as necessary. Relationships is where you'll add any related clients, such as a spouse, sibling, or parent. This provides a shortcut between both profiles using a link, and also enables more advanced abilities, like having one sibling pay for another, or a spouse share their pricing options. In the billing information section, you can add a credit card to the client's account or ACH information if they're on an autopay. Registration information displays the client's booked enrollments or workshops, and you may use the date range to filter through them. The client photo, located in the top middle, can be uploaded from your computer or taken from the Mindbody business app. The referred by section enables you to add the person who referred this client to your business, if there was one. Depending on your settings, this can give them account credit. The member status section shows you if the client has an active membership. You'll also be able to prevent the client from booking by scheduling a suspension start and end date. History will show you when the client's profile was created and who created it, as well as their contact log information. The client types and client indexes sections can be used to assign specific filters to the client. The client will then be included in those filters when you generate your reports and mailing lists. In the custom fields sections, you may enter additional client information to use for the client search on the advanced client lookup screen. The notes and alerts sections are similar, but used slightly differently. With notes, you'll be entering in general information about the client. For instance, any preferences or past history that's important to remember. The alerts are more for one-time issues, like an out-of-date credit card, missing payment, or something else that a staff member would need to be aware of as a priority. Formula notes are short messages that will appear on the modified appointment screen. You may save as many notes as you want, and each will be timestamped with the date. If the client had a sales rep, you may enter them in the rep section. Lastly, you can view any applicable ICD code in the ICD section. When finished, click the blue Save button at the bottom or in the top right corner to complete your changes.